keep seeing more and more people posting videos about what's happening to the enemies of chosen ones. It's becoming like trending now to say that you're chosen. It's insulting. I think that we all have to stop, because I mean, and I'm talking to myself, because I still was up to a certain, like a few days ago, listening to certain people that I know that are frauds. I know that they're getting karmic justice from the universe, and I know that we're not supposed to be watching or listening to these people. At this point, we're wasting our time. I was to the point where I'm human, just like everybody else, and I know that somebody's a fraud, especially when it's a reader and my guides expose them. But I listen to them because I can tell that they're not gifted. It's like, and then I found myself getting petty, but like I said, I'm fucking human, you know, and this is part of also just being authentic, is admitting the shit that you can be petty sometimes, but it's a waste of our time now, I feel like. There was a dude, there's a lot of people claiming to be chosen, you know, your enemies are doing this and your enemies are doing that, and then like, I'll scroll on all of these people's videos, and there's nothing about their personal journey on there at all. They just started a channel talking about I'm chosen. I can put the word chosen there, and because that's what people are drawn to now. The real chosen ones, like the ones who were chosen to make a huge difference in this world, the ones that were chosen for specific missions, and they talk about it, it's because once you know that person's mission, and so do they, there's no denying that they were chosen for that specific thing. No one's chosen just to say that they're fucking chosen, okay? That just means that you chose to start a channel and talk about other chosen people. Real chosen ones can sniff them out. We're like dogs. We're like fucking bloodhounds. So I think it's time to, and myself included, be careful what you're even allowing your subconscious to take in. I almost feel, because I test these theories, and it's crazy, I test these theories, and I even put my own money on the line, where when I start watching certain people, and my guides have already exposed them to me for who they are, whether they're racist or they're jealous, a lot of them are both, unhealed, competitive, secretly doing spell work, but yet talking about people doing it. What does that make us if we know and our pendulums have confirmed that these people are in fact that and doing that, and now we're watching it? Do we get karma in some way? Because karma's, it's harsh, and then it's just something that nudges you a little bit to put you back on the right path. My money slows down. My donations and stuff slow down when I watch a certain few people. When I stopped and cut it out, my donations went up. My money went up. So I'm wondering if we actually, once we're given the messages and we confirm the shit and we know that somebody's a fraud or they're a liar or they're you know, they're just a fucking jealous, competitive, racist bitch or dude, I honestly think that that's our guides telling us like to not put our energy towards that person or those people anymore. Because what are you getting from it? I feel like once we get to a certain vibration, our brains are such sponges. And like when you get to a certain frequency, you manifest things very quickly. So I do feel like a lot of us have to be careful what we're putting our attention towards. Even with my videos, they're not going to be for everybody every day. Ask your pendulum if this message is true and if this message is something that you need to listen to. And if it says no, then don't. Like, but there are certain people where we were, I feel like it was proven multiple times between myself, other people, that they're liars and they're frauds, and they got some secrets that they're not talking about. So I don't know, you use your discernment, but honest, from this point on, I have to put my petty side aside, because that's the only reason that these people were even getting my attention at all, is almost for like mocking reasons, you know, because I still have that side to me, but I don't really like that side to me, and I don't gain anything, because there's someone in particular that my guides have been hitting on, and I would listen to this person, one, because I was counting the number of times they said okay during their messages, and that was me being petty, and I can do that if I want, you know, I admit to being petty. Does it make it better? No, but that just is who I am, but then I also just would find them tripping up on their words. And then when they would say something as if it was affirmative that they knew about spirituality, like, you know, if you do this or you pull cards on somebody and don't ask for their permission, or you didn't clear out your karma and you pull cards on somebody, I don't know where the fuck this bitch is getting this information at. My pendulum says no way too much for somebody that I feel like that's just my guide's way now of telling me, like, you're wasting your time. There's nothing to even mock. This person is not who they said they were, and you're not getting anything from this. As I was clicking off of that and decided, like, I really, all I do is make fun of this person, and, like, that's going to make me just like them, all of these videos started flooding on my timeline from supposed chosen ones and what's up with your enemies and this, that, or the other. And that's all they got, though. That's their whole channel, is just people talking about what's going on with their enemies. And when I tell you that 9 out of 10 of these videos, when I ask, is this person actually chosen? I'm pretty sure it's 144,000 is what the book said, didn't it? So this is why people who truly are, when they create channels, we don't expect to have millions of subscribers. Because the only people that can really deal or understand chosen ones or even put up with their energy are other people who are in that energy or close to that energy. So we're not going to be the ones right now who have millions of views and hundreds of thousands of subscribers, because we're not really liked too much. You feel me? So take that for what it's worth. Put your energy and shit towards something or someone that can help you get clarity, and then it can help you grow, and that is authentic to who they say they are. It's crucial. Otherwise, that the universe is going to start bringing us what we're putting our attention towards. And if we're putting our attention towards people who we know are frauds anyway, just because, then that's exactly what the universe is going to send to us. I am talking to myself as well. We're not going nowhere. Authentic or nothing. Love you. Philly out.